Now the portion of the opening ceremony artistic director Zhang Yimou refers to as Confucius Travels, as 810 disciples of Confucius appear holding bamboo scrolls.
Bob, yeah, we're back here in one of the really powerful Chinese traditions, Confucian thought. Confucius was a scholar who lived 2,500 years ago in an unbelievably chaotic time in Chinese history known as the Spring and Autumn period, who wandered around giving advice to leaders about how to have order, how to have harmony in a society.
And the bamboo scrolls, if anyone asks the question, what's significant about holding the Olympics in China? Well, how many places could you go around the world where the culture is old enough where you can say, oh, by the way, the Chinese invented paper and printing, and that's actually true here.
And in fact, this is a symbolic statement, as we see in the middle of the stadium right now, the bamboo giving way piece by piece and then rising up from the center of the stage now, Chinese movable printing blocks. Moving blocks, which are eliciting quite a reaction here in the bird's nest, are evoking something that many Chinese viewers will recognize. This is wind, and recalls one of Confucius's most famous phrases, the idea that the virtuous leader can pass across his subjects with the ease of the wind.
Time after time, we've seen it in this opening ceremony already. Massive scope, minute precision.
And there is the Chinese character for harmony, which will make a number of appearances tonight. A core philosophical conception.
And a core political ideal as well. Hu Jintao talks constantly about the harmonious society.
That's right. The idea of a Hexia Shehui, or a harmonious society, really right at the heart of Chinese political doctrine at the moment.
Glad you said that.
Here, by the way, is another image that evokes that same tradition, the notion of drops of water spilling onto an empty pond, that sort of stillness and silence that comes from Confucian self-cultivation, but also appears, of course, in the Taoist and the Buddhist traditions as a mark of inner peace leading to external peace. And there's the character for harmony again. You know, one of the unusual things about spending so much time talking about harmony in China today is there are so many profoundly disharmonious things here, in a way, the challenges with the environment, with urbanization, and so forth. So this is really representing an ideal for the Chinese as they watch this.
I think you said it so well, Bob, earlier. This is Zhang Yimou creating a cinematic blockbuster in real time on the floor of a stadium.
Harmony making its third appearance there.
Mm-hmm.
And now a symbol that is perhaps the most famous in China, the Great Wall, 4,000 miles long, built and rebuilt over almost a 1,000-year period as this country tried to keep barbarians out. And now in a moment of symbolism that is just remarkable, the director Zhang Yimou brings the Great Wall down and replaces it with blossoming plum flowers, the Chinese symbol for openness.
Again, the reconciling of opposites.
Absolutely, and again, a desire to replace one image of China with another one.
And how'd they do it? They did it with people. Not computers, not hydraulics, people. It's unbelievable.
Jaw-dropping. Don't go away. Why would you?